So good evening, everyone. It is indeed a pleasure to have you all in this Art Integration in Science webinar. We've been having a series of webinars in these days. We've already completed with English, Maths, and so on. And since there were a lot of people who wanted to for science, we thought that this is a good day to organize for science as well. So on behalf of the Delhi Teachers Forum, I extend a hearty welcome to all the participants. And especially to our moderator for the day, Prithika Bhandari ma'am, who has taken the initiative in organizing this integration of science in arts. To explain you about the new CBSE notification that was released that how do we integrate art into science. And this is especially mandatory for class 9 and 10 where we have to do it subject wise. So I'm sure you're going to have an enriching experience. So all the best, Ritika ma'am. I'm handing over the proceedings to you. You can start. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Matthew, sir. Thank you for giving me the opportunity. Good evening and a very warm welcome to everyone. A very warm welcome to Principal Ma'am Gurpreet Singh from Guru Har Krishan Public School, Hemkund Colony. A very warm welcome to Headmistress Ma'am, Mrs. Nagra. A very warm welcome to Mr. Mukesh Chand, who is Principal Balwant Rai Mehta School. I welcome you all. Thanks for sparing your valuable time and being with me for this art integration with science. Thank you very much. And I am very happy. I'm very happy to see the enthusiastic participants also who were keen to get such kind of webinar on integration of art and science. And as Matthew sir has already told us that in CBSE curriculum now, this is a very, very important part. And we have to do these activities. We have to integrate science. And we have been doing this. We actually have been doing a lot of exhibitions, science exhibitions. We have been making models. We have been making posters. So we have been integrating art and science. But in today's workshop, in today's webinar, I would try to bring up some new activities which we can actually start with the new integration techniques, and especially classes 9th and 10th, where we have to make the projects also, and classes first to class 8, where we have to have integration activities also. So we all know that art has many forms. It is performing art, it is visual art, it is craft. So many things are there. So the first thing, before starting with anything, I want to ask all of you, and please answer in the chat, what is your interest in any form? Everyone doesn't do everything. Some people are good at dance. Some people are good at drama. Some people are good at other activities, maybe art and craft, maybe quilling, maybe painting, maybe anything. Please, I really want all of you to introspect yourself and find out what exactly you people love to do. That's good. I'm getting answers: cartoon painting, dance, drama, craft, yoga, sports, great, baking. Right. So here we all are having different interests. And I'm really happy that, yes, so many things are coming up: dance and drama, mono acting, best out of waste, drawing. Similarly, in a class of 30 to 40 students, we have different students, their different interests. And one thing we have to start is that we have to find the interest of our children. We have to find what are they best into, what can they do, and we have to design our projects in that way, so that we have the maximum participation of the students. Maybe if we are designing something, we bring in students who are good at painting, they are good at dancing, they are good at drama, and we are doing such projects and such activities where everybody is coming. Because when we talk of science exhibitions, only 4, 5, 6 students are there. But here we want the maximum participation. So today when I'll be talking about all the activities, would like to see that most of the students get participation in their activities. So, starting with today's session, so the first thing is, what is art integration? What exactly is art integration? As CBSC has also said that we have to integrate art with science. So what exactly is art integration? What are we presenting in the form of art integration? So we start with the first slide about what is art integration. Can we have the first slide, please? Yes. So what is the main role of art integration? We want to develop important skills in children. We want to have self-reflective students. We want them to develop their vocabulary. We want abstract thinking from them. And we want them to explore and investigate. That is the main thing we want in art integration. And when children are doing this in their academics, this becomes a very, very important part of their development if we are looking for the holistic development. Next slide, please. Now, this is the roadmap. As already discussed by Mr. Matthew, we need to have art education as an integral part up to classes 10. We have to have a minimum of 2 periods per week per class for the art education. And we have to cover main spheres, music, dance, visual art, and craft. But we need to have culinary skills also. So culinary skills is also one of the important thing that has to be kept in mind. So we can talk about the crops, we can talk about the spices, we can talk about the agricultural practices. Just like, you know, Delhi has been given Sikkim. So we have to make projects based with Sikkim. So in Sikkim, we can talk about their crops. We can talk
about...
Can you please mute yourself? So this curriculum needs to have even the culinary art also as a part of art integration. Can we have the next slide about the methodologies? So when we are talking about the methodologies, there are various ways. There it could be role play, it could be graphics, it could be visuals, it could be art, it could be dance, it could be drama, it could be comic strips, it could be poetry. There are n number of ways, there are infinite number of ways in which we can bring integration of science and arts. The thing is, we have to find how to do it, and that I'll be discussing in the later part. Can we have the next slide? So this is the rubrics, how we are assessing the children, the parameters as well as the levels. So when I talk about the parameters, we have to see the understanding of the art form, their creativity, the relevance with the theme, their application, and craftsmanship. And when we are talking about the levels, we have to see that whether a child is just a beginner or he or she is proficient or showing exemplary effects in the work that has been done by the children. So these are certain rubrics. These are all available on the CBSE sites. So you people can just go through that, and this is how we need to assess them. Now we come to the checklist. So one thing we have to keep in mind, that we are looking for experiential learning. We want construction, we want demonstrations, but we should not put any financial burden for the students. So whatever activities we are designing, we need to have minimum amount of burden, financial burden to the students, and let them enjoy, let them come out with their ideas, let them be self-reflective. That is the need of the hour. We should not impose our activities. We should get ideas from the children, because these days children are smarter than us. If we give them some situation, how they will handle, that is the main thing that teachers have to keep in mind
before designing any activity. So we'll start with the first video. But before that, we have a model of art integration. This is also given on the CBSE side, where they say that whenever you are introducing a topic, you have to have an ice-breaking activity in the class. Then you select the topic, then give them opportunities, especially for the hands-on activities. And then they should show their reflection. And finally, we can assess the students. So this is how we have to go about the activities we will talk about. And then we'll have the first video. I'll start with the first performance. I want you to see it attentively. Hope the video runs well. And then we will discuss something on that.
Is the screen visible to all?
That's why neutrophils are the muscular cells of the body.
Yes.
Neutrophils?
Is it so complicated? See, that's what happens when I try to explain my PhD project to anyone. What should I do? Let me dance it out.
Neutrophils are the white blood cells, which are an essential part of the immune system, constantly flowing in our bloodstream. Foreign bodies that attack the healthy cells and create infection. Neutrophils are the first immune cells that reach the site of infection. That's not all. Neutrophils also form nets in non-infectious disease like gout.
We just saw a video. I hope you people enjoyed that video. And that's an academic dance-off. This has to be put up on YouTube for physics, chemistry, biology, or social sciences every year. And this is something which gets a prize of $500 for the winner. And the overall winner gets additional $5,000 and a visit to Stanford University. So here we have what we have seen is that with PhD projects, if people can come up with dance activities, can't we have it with our class 8, 9, 10th or 11th students? Yes, we can. We have the opportunities, and here it's just not dance. Maybe in a class of 30 to 40, your students, maybe 5, 6 or 7 are interested in dance. But then in such kind of activities, you can use other students in a way. Some are good at music. Some are good at script writing. Some are good at prop making. So they can make the props. They can make the masks. The art and craft people can be there. So in such activities, most of the class students get involved. And if we are designing such activities, we think, okay, such dance and drama can be for, you know, primary students. But can't we have it for senior students as well? Yes. So dance is generally very enriching. Active movement is there and children enjoy. And whenever they are given such roles and they are performing and they visualize, they actually enjoy. So they imbibe the knowledge of concepts also, and they enjoy working with such things. So this is one thing we can do with dance. For example, suppose I'm talking about ozone layer depletion. Now in ozone layer depletion, we have three oxygen molecules, three oxygen atoms together. So we can have like three students. And then we know that because of chlorofluorocarbons or freons, it gets diminished. So what we do is maybe in the form they can throw the balls like chlorofluorocarbons, and then we can show the nitrous oxides or something like that, and the bond between O3 breaks into O2 plus nascent oxygen. So two students stay together and one goes back. I'm just giving you an example. There can be n number of ways where we can actually have dance as one of the activity to integrate with science. And I think children will be enjoying this because they will like. Please, participants, mute yourself because the background sound I am getting is really disturbing me. And it's actually distracting everyone. It's a request to all of you, please mute yourself. So I hope this activity can be done. Dance is one thing which is very creative, and that builds a lot of confidence in students also. After this, we have music. Music is also another form which students love to do, and how we are integrating with science. So we will again have a video where we can see how music and science go together. Can we have that video, please? It's a request. Please mute yourself, everyone. So when we talk about the music, we can have different ways in which music can be integrated with science. It could be with the elements of the periodic table, which you will be just listening. And this was done by a person, Tom Lehrer, in the year 1959. So just imagine 1959, this musical humorist, he brought a song with the elements, and whatever elements were known at that time, he sang it beautifully. And I'm very sure that if you will tell your students to hear this, they will also really enjoy. After so many years, they will enjoy this particular song. So we'll play this song. Let's see how it comes up. And when students are actually
to a Gilbert and Sullivan tune. I think the only reason I do it is to see if I still can. We'll try. There's antimony, arsenic, aluminum, selenium, and hydrogen, and oxygen, and nitrogen, and rhenium, and nickel, neodymium, neptunium, germanium, and iron, americium, ruthenium, uranium, europium, zirconium, lutetium, vanadium, and lanthanum, and osmium, and astatine, and radium, and gold, which actinium, and indium, and gallium, and iodine, and thorium, and thulium, and thallium. Azotrium, terbium, actinium, rubidium, boron, gadolinium, niobium, iridium, and strontium, and silicon, and silver, and samarium, and bismuth, bromine, lithium, beryllium, and barium. I left out one, actually. A new one was discovered since the song was written. It's called Lawrencium. So those of you who are taking notes can write it down in your programs. There's holmium and helium and hafnium and erbium and phosphorus and francium and fluorine and terbium and manganese and mercury and molybdenum and magnesium and dysprosium and scandium and cerium and cesium and lead, praseodymium and platinum, plutonium, palladium, promethium, potassium, polonium, tantalum, technetium, titanium, tellurium, and cadmium and calcium and chromium and curium. There's gold and californium and fermium and berkelium and also metallium, einsteinium, nobelium and argon, kryptonium, radon, zinc, nitrogen, and rhodium and chlorine, carbon, cobalt, copper, tungsten, tin, and sodium. These are the only ones of which the news has come to Harvard. And there may be many others, but they haven't been discovered.
So, honestly speaking, how many of us have shared this song with our students? I want yes, no. Even I haven't shared it as such. Frankly speaking, when I was, you know, doing research for this webinar, I came across this and it is so interesting. We have never ever shared with our students. And when, you know, our students are so happy with raps, when they can, you know, sing that Gully Boys wala song and Baba Sehgal can sing a lot of Corona song and everything, and our kids actually acquire it, why can't we? Why can't we give them some definitions? Why can't we give them some clues? What, even in physics, it's chemistry, it's biology, anything you give them and tell them to come up with a rap and they will enjoy. And I'm telling you, they will actually love to do such activities. They will start loving science. See, if you just have a survey, what you will see is that most of the students, they are not very much interested in science and maths. They're more interested in art. So when we are integrating, we are actually developing interest. And such kind of activities will really, really make them happy. You can find this on YouTube easily and share with the students. And yes, I'm getting a lot of messages from you. Thank you so much. It is very, very interesting and children would love. Now, after this, I have two guest speakers with me from National Institute of Fashion Technology, Bhumika Dutt and Shivam Bhandari. They are the people who are actually from the science background and they are doing a lot of artwork. And when I discussed with them, they started with such good activities. They will bring 8 activities and I'm happy that they are with me today. They have spared their time to be here and share their activities with you. And you people will actually enjoy all these activities they have brought. So I welcome Shivam Bhandari and Bhumika Dutt. Please, you can start.
Greetings to everyone present in this webinar. Just to confirm with the chat box that either you can hear me or not.
Yeah, Bhumika, you are audible.
Okay. Thank you so much, Ritika ma'am. Thank you so much for now. We feel privileged that we are here today and addressing all of the teachers present here. So I'll start with a short note. I am a fashion communication student in National Institute of Fashion Technology. We deal with science and art on a daily basis. And being a science student in school and opting such a different stream, people think that it's weird, but if in my perspective, if you will integrate science with art, you can do wonders to this difficult known subject called as science. So moving forward to our activity, which is our first activity. Now all of us have learned about leaves, the fundamental function of leaves, the way it makes food in a tree. So to understand more about this activity, we are introducing this exercise. So the materials required for this exercise are really easily available and cheap, which can be crayons, oil pastels, pencil colors, etc., or even a pencil, but color pencils would be preferred. Students of 5th to 8th standard can participate in this activity proficiently. And such an activity could be more interesting for the students because they will be knowing how the actual leaf looks like. And they'll get to know by tracing the leaf on a paper, on a sheet of paper, and learning about the actual veins and margins of a leaf. And labeling them would be really fun, watching these colorful leaves all over. Can you change the slide, please? Next slide. So the second activity. So I'll use a self-reference while explaining this activity. I never understood such concept of vigor and interference really quickly. It took me a while to understand all this. So, because as kids, we give the tag of a difficult phenomena of to such theories. So, such kind of experiments can make it easy and simple to understand. So, materials required for this experiment is just a bowl of water, of course, clear nail polish, and sheets of paper, specifically black sheets, and paper towels because cleanliness is important. Can you change the slide, please? Okay, the science behind it. So if you dip the paper on the water surface where we have already dropped plain nail polish. So when we do it, so a thin film of interference will be created on the sheet of paper. And through the thick and thin layers of nail polish on the different areas on the paper, it will have a different color which is showed. Light will fall on the different surfaces and which will create a film of interference as we have seen in the rainy days when oil on water surface makes it look like a rainbow. So understanding the colors of vigor and formation of rainbow can be really interactive for students, and obviously practical aspects will always help them to understand the experiment quickly. Can you change the slide? So this is how it will look, and this is very interesting, and this is very interesting for the kids because they'll make their own vigor sheet, and it's very interactive too, and it's very simple.
Hello.
Moving forward, I will hand over this presentation to my friend Shivam Bhandari.
Welcome all to this webinar. Just in the chat box, can you write, am I audible or not?
Yeah, you are audible.
Okay, first of all, before starting to the next activity, I would like to first acknowledge the fact and thank everybody, especially Matthew sir and Ritika ma'am, for letting us into this amazing webinar. Without wasting much time, I would like to start with the activity which we have designed. First activity is of magnetic painting. Now, this activity can be used for students from class 5th to class 8th in order to understand the metallic character of a substance. And this would also create a very beautiful painting or installations for them. Now, the material which is required in order to make this painting is you need DIY metallic magnetic substance like screw, bolt, ball bearings, and certain items, and you have to just dip it in the paint. After dipping in the paint, you have to place it over a tray with the white sheet on it, as you can see in the presentation. And you have to take a piece of magnet and place it beneath the tray. When you move the tray, when you move the magnet, the substances on the surface of the tray will also move and will create beautiful patterns. Through this, we can also add certain non-magnetic substances such as plastic pieces, such as wood, and we can make students understand that the metallic magnetic substances are moving, but the non-magnetic substances are not moving. The next activity which we want to discuss is chromatography. Again, from classes 8th to 11th, this activity can be practiced. And this activity works on the principle of surface chemistry, which is adsorption. And the material required for this is non-permanent marker, Wattman filter paper, pencil, a cup of water, and black fancy yarn. The procedure for this particular activity is that we need to take a Wattman filter paper, cut it into a circle, and using a marker, we need to make a circle around the center of the filter. Then we need to convert it into a shape of a cone and dip it in a cup of water. Just make sure that the ink part is not dipped in the water. The plain area is only dipped. After some time, you will see the colors being separated and creating beautiful patterns. Let it dry for some time, and then by using fancy yarns, you can make butterflies and other objects out of it. The next activity, Bhumika, can you please explain this?
So the next activity, it's the most important one because reduction of plastic and proper disposal of waste is very important for our students as well as teachers. And it's very important for them to understand that how to dispose it. So this is a very interesting exercise, best out of waste. So everything which you find waste in your house, I mean, it's really sad to see the piles of garbage on the roadside, which is filled with broken ceramics and plastic, which harms our animals. So just to resolve this can be a very good initiative by students and teachers. So the materials required are plastic caps, which are waste, bottle crowns, coins, old china plates, mostly broken, beads, threads, buttons, jewelry, which is not in use specifically. Can you change the slide, please? So as you can see, these installations can be made on some functions which we do in our schools, like annual days and some other functions. And this will also create an emotion of nobility inside the students that they did something to save the environment. And specifically, this will create a love for wild animals and especially for marine animals, because plastic harms them the most. Okay, so this is my favorite one because I am also a communication designer, so logo making. So first we should understand that what is a logo. Logo is a presentation of any word or phenomena on the basis of their properties and visual identity. So as you know, that periodic table is very difficult to memorize. Like I was really suffering in understanding the periodic table and memorizing the periodic table. So what can be the solutions? As Ritika ma'am showed you one video also in the starting, the Song of Periodic Table. So these are also some initiatives that we can take. So as you can see on the screen, we have made some symbols of the metals and non-metals in the periodic table. And as we play the scribble game, in which we make words using alphabets. So this can also increase the vocabulary of the students. As you can see, lithium and iron's initials made life, chocolate, genius, princess. So these are some ways where students will be really happy to learn the periodic table. Plus, they will increase their vocabulary. And in the center of the slide, you can see a clock where metals and non-metals having atomic number from 1 to 12 are presented. And this is very interactive, that you'll also memorize or you'll count the atomic number of this metal or non-metal, and you have masses also, so you can calculate that. So it's very interactive, and we can place it in the classrooms, or we can make it a puzzle in the classroom for the kids. So yeah, it will help them in memorizing the periodic table and understanding it more. Now my friend Shivam will take over the activities. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Bhumika, for those innovative yet simple activities. Taking the list forward, next we are going to discuss is pendulum painting. This is the most basic but most innovative painting which I have come across. And being in NIFT, and we have a lot of art festivals and annual functions, I have personally practiced this form of painting in making one or two installations. So the very basic fundamental, science fundamental, which is being involved in making this activity is simple harmonic motion, Newton's first law, gravity and inertia. The materials required for this particular activity is a paper cup, paint and a canvas sheet, or any other A3, A4 sheet would be comfortable. The procedure for this particular activity is you need to take a paper cup and pierce the bottom of the cup. After piercing, put a tape on that particular hole and pour paint into the cup. Then we need to suspend this particular cup using a tripod, or you can use two chairs and a broomstick kept vertical, and you just have to suspend the cup. After suspending the cup, we need to swing the cup, and when we swing the cup, now physics comes into play, and when we swing the cup, it forms a very beautiful pattern. There are certain examples in the presentation, as you can see, using just a paper cup and a suspended tripod, we can create such beautiful psychedelic patterns. The next activity which we are going to discuss is quilled anatomy. Quilling is one of my favorite art form, and when I was in first year, we have a subject in NIFT by the name of material exploration, in which paper handling techniques have been taught, and we have been taught paper quilling, paper weaving. So what quilling is, we just use small strips of paper and we need to roll them into a certain form and then paste it using adhesive. Now, as you can see in the image, a neuron structure, human heart, human digestive system, DNA, and a lot of diagrams can be made out of quilling. And this not only is easy for students to understand, but they will also understand the position, then the nomenclature of that particular thing inside our body. Because it is very difficult for us to imagine an amoeba or a mitochondria or cell structures like that. So by making, and again, we can use it in making installations and other activities. So these would be the activities which we have shared. A lot of you have written that kindly share the activities. We'll try to share as many as possible after the meeting.
Thank you, Bhumika and Shivam. I hope I'm audible.
Yes.
Yeah, thank you so much. With such wonderful activities and such simple activities you have come up, it's really very innovative ideas are there, and they can easily be used by us. So I hope my teachers are actually enjoying all these activities, and I hope we can go further on with one more webinar on this if we start thinking on such processes also. So this is one way. Art and craft is one way where we can actually come up with lot of ideas and lot of integration of art with science. Now, before moving on to the next topic, just a small request. We will be floating, and we have already floated one Google form for your attendance. So please fill it up so that we know who all have attended that. And for the certificates also, please fill in the Google form which is floated in the chat box. Okay, so after this, we have some other ideas like poetry. Can I have the screen, please? Poetry, drama, and comic strip. These are also very innovative ideas when we come for science integration. And when I was doing my research, I found something called as haiku. How many of you know what is haiku? Have you ever heard of haiku? Yes, haiku is a poetry. It is a poetry which has come from Japanese people, and it is a three-liner poetry. As you can see on the screen, for hydrogen, they have written your single proton, fundamental, essential, water, life, star, fuel. For carbon, show stealing diva, throw yourself at anyone decked out in diamond. For lithium, lighter than water, empower batteries, banish depression. So yes, haiku is a Japanese word. It is a poem, and that poem has been used for elements. And in a country like India, where we have so many languages, we have such a diversity. Can't we come up with such innovative ideas? Can't we make some simple things for the students, or let the students see these things and come up with their innovative ideas? So poetry is also one form which can be used when we are talking about integration of art with science. Can we have the next slide, please? Yes. Role play and drama. Again, this is a very important, as you can see, a concept being shown on the screen, where how X chromosome and Y chromosome, and how we can have the sex determination. So children are playing that, a role play is there. And we can have role play in many things. We can have in structure of atoms, we can have a role play. In structure of a cell, we can, you know, tell them one to be mitochondria, one to be Golgi apparatus, and so on. And then they can come up with their structures and functions. So dance, drama, role play, all such activities will actually enhance their interest in science. And believe me, once they are into this, right from the primary levels, if they are doing all these activities, they will start enjoying the subject. And if they enjoy the subject, if they understand the subject, what else do people want? So if we want that our children are self-reflective, our children know how to speak, you know, this all will also improve their communication skills, their leadership qualities, their communication skills. Everything will be enhanced if we are taking all such things into consideration when we are going for any role plays and dramas. So there are an infinite number of possibilities. The only thing is we have to think, we have to ponder, and we have to apply how. Right from beginning, from primary to class 12th, we can do it. Yes, we can do it. There are many other ways of doing it. So dance, drama, role play, poetry, and the last one is comic strips. Comic strips are also very interesting way, just like posters, and children actually enjoy. So you can see here that lost an electron, are you sure you are all right? And thou, he says, I'm positive. So how do children remember that after losing an electron, they acquire a positive charge? All such small things have to be given to them in such ways. Comics are excellent examples where we can actually give ideas to children. You can see three examples are there on the screen about the sound. And you know, when the children are drawing and they are making such patterns and they're coming up with their ideas and then they discuss with each other, they come up with illustrations. This actually improves a lot of their academic as well as their art form. So such ideas can be floated. I hope you people understood. Now this is the form in the chat box, because so many people are asking about the Google form. This has been floated twice, thrice. Please fill in the form before we end. And I hope you people have enjoyed these activities. Now, if you have any questions, you can ask. If any one of you wants to come up with any of the activity, please come up. This is a platform where we can all share with each other and we can learn from each other. So my request to you is that in case you need to ask something or you want to come up with anything, you are most welcome. I'm really happy that all the participants were very enthusiastic, and I hope our ideas are easy ones and you people have enjoyed. So anyone, if you want to speak something, you want to ask something, you're most welcome. We have another 2-3 minutes, 4 minutes. We can continue this.
Good evening, Ritika ma'am.
Good evening, Komal ma'am.
Good evening, Matthew sir. I am Anisha Sharma here. So I really enjoyed the session. It was wonderful, wonderful. While you were talking about dance and music, since I'm very much interested in dance and music, so I would share one of the examples. So it's about last year, while I was teaching periodic properties in class 10, we started making rap for the rap song for the element. So one of my students, she made a beautiful rap and she learned all the elements of the periodic table through that rap. And I still have that recording. If possible, I will share it someday with the PTF group. So I really enjoyed, and last part of the session was very, very interesting. I really never knew that paintings can be done in so many ways, since I'm not into very much painting part, but I really learned with these two people, and I'm going to do that, follow that in my classes for sure. So it was really an enriching session, and I totally enjoyed it. Thank you for conducting it. Thanks a lot to all of you, because you have really worked very, very hard for this. So thank you.
Thank you, Manisha ma'am. I'm really happy to hear the ideas from you also. And we must be sharing, because nobody is a perfect learner, and we have to be learners and we have to actually exchange ideas with each other. That is the main thing. I have come up with something. You people can actually come up with your ideas and we can discuss. This is a common platform for us to discuss, and especially in this unprecedented time where we can't have the seminars. This is the best opportunity which has been given. There are people who are asking about Sikkim. Yes, Sikkim is there with Delhi, and we can talk, as I told you, about the crops, about even in dance, their dance form is related with harvesting festivals. So harvesting festivals, and if you want a multidisciplinary project with class up till 8th, you can have integration of social science and science also in the crops, in the type of dance and everything. So we can do that part also, but we're talking about integration with Sikkim. Anyone else who wants to ask or say something?
Hello?
Yes.
Hello?
Hello?
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Okay, it was... Ritika, it was... I'm Gurpreet saying, Ritika, it was wonderful. And I'm
Thank
sure...
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Even classes below class 5 can achieve a lot through this. I'm yes, sure ma'am. Poems can do very well. And it was really wonderful. Looking forward again with some more
thank
ideas.
You so, thank you thank so you. Much, ma'am. You are a big motivation for me, and you're always giving me opportunities to do all these things. Thank you so much for attending this, ma'am. I'm really, really very happy you enjoyed this. Anyone else who wants to come up?
Oh, yes, ma'am. Meenakshi Narula this side. Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes. Yes.
I would like to thank you, ma'am, for the such wonderful ideas. Though I have been teaching quilling, I'm a science teacher as well. But in quilling, I just made earrings, other craft things, and I've never imagined like this kind of, you see, your different internal organs can be also shown through
yes.
quilling. It's wonderful.
Yes,
ma'am. Thank
yes.
you so much.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much. This is how we can just exchange our ideas, ma'am. And
hello, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am, please.
Hello, ma'am.
Hanji, ma'am.
Hello. I'm also BGD Chemistry from St. Xavier's Rohini. I wish what we could do for the 12th class. See, this time we are facing such a lot of problem with the syllabus also. How to go about such things? See, Osarno and all we have there in the B block. How to go about with the present batch?
See, ma'am, again, if we are talking about the P blocks and all elements, when they have to learn all these elements, I have given you already the ideas. Put some music, put something. You know, when I was going through the Sikkim thing, and I just made a research about the Thanga paintings and everything in Sikkim, what I found was that the original colors they used to have were from copper salts. And some rock material which had, you know, monoclinic structure or something like that. So in that case, you know, if we can combine it with solid state, we can combine it with many other things. So we need to explore. We actually need to explore. That is one thing which is required.
Nee, I got your idea, ma'am. It's already, I have made a assembly also, formation of elements, HCl, Cl2O2 and all. That we could do. But in this pandemic situation, how could we go about only to ask the children to do online like this?
Ma'am,
or like
there are so many softwares, and they can actually, you know, you can give ideas to children and they can come up with they can use softwares to have all those things. I have a meiosis song. I'll just show you people and how wonderfully it has been explaining. So you can float the ideas and let the kids come up with something. And these
okay.
days, I'm telling...
Okay, Ritika, ma'am. Thank you very much for the inspiration.
So you can have this bit of this song. You will enjoy how they're using the graphics, how they're using the softwares for creating such interesting things.
Okay,
can you play
ma'am.
This?
Good idea. Good idea.
Special cell division, sexual reproduction. Meiosis happens to an entire organism to reproduce. With two cell divisions, the daughter cells marry genetically. Four daughter cells made when finished, created from a single parent. Their new daughter cells are the home, each one has other chromosomes. Haploid other chromosomes, only produce. sex cells we call gametes. First part is meiosis, one homologous chromosome split up. Prophase chromosomes, XX structures, two sister chromatodes identical. Copies pair up together, exchange bits of DNA. Process called recombination, also crossing over. Metaphase pairs line up next and gathered into the center. Opposite pole centrioles, meiotic spindles. And anaphase one, chromosomes are both apart. Two opposite spindle poles. Telophase and cytokinesis. Each pole has a set of chromosomes gathering. Membrane forms, creates nuclei. 23 chromosomes each completed.
So hope you people have enjoyed this form also. This is also very interesting. And believe me, when we are sharing, these things are all available on YouTube. We just need to find them out, share with your children, and the things will become very easy for them. So just before finishing up, I'll just like to say that yes, we have to integrate science with art, but one thing we have to keep in mind, that tell your children to have art of living. Art of living doesn't mean that I am a Shri Shri disciple, but yes, tell them to handle all goods and bads, success and failure. They should not get demotivated. Make them happy. Enjoy yourself. As a teacher, enjoy yourself. I enjoy teaching when I come up with such ideas. I'm telling you, this was all because I enjoy this. So start enjoying as a teacher and you love children and how well they will come up with their ideas. You will also be very, very happy. So I think we should be just over with this session. I hope you people have enjoyed. Thank you everyone to be here and participating in this. I'm really, really, really thankful to all of you that you have come here and we have shared ideas. Thank you very much. So
thank you.
Hello,
good evening, ma'am.
Good evening.
Just got connected now only. I attended your session for the first 15 minutes, then got disconnected somehow because of poor network at my end, but found it extremely useful for those first 20 minutes also. And now I have connected, I got just connected right now. Please, can you please share the recording?
Yes, ma'am. Sure.
Look at the recording.
I had sent the WhatsApp. I'll be sharing the recording on YouTube also. Don't worry. It would be in the name of Delhi School Teachers Forum and Science Integration. You can find it on YouTube also.
Delhi School Teachers Forum.
Yeah. And you will get it within 3-4 days.
Thank you so much, ma'am. I found it extremely useful.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. So we call it for a day. Thank you so much. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.